The amount of integration, number of allies we've got to fly with and stuff is has been phenomenal. We've got a bunch of first-time experience for a bunch of young guys doing dissimilar BFM, so it's a really fun environment to come out and learn from each other and also put the jet through its paces, specifically in the fit week and now that we're starting the kind of ACT long-range week. We leverage the information and all the experience from all the PACAF units in order to essentially pass the clues and the hints and the tips and the tricks from everybody, so we call it gouge, in order to get us established. Initially, the 90th was a frag to come out here, and things changed. For what reason, I don't know, but they were kind enough to basically attach their projos to our projos, and they've actually been here flying and integrating with us, so the transition's been relatively easy. Kind of one Raptor squadron is in each. Just the other, you know what I mean? Yeah. So we didn't really have to change much. We just went with their plan. I think the education piece for our younger guys of how the foreign governments that we're not used to flying with, and the integration piece of just how do you get 20 different nations in the same room around the same map with a like objective, and then leverage all of the strengths of those assets in order to achieve those objectives, I think is the biggest learning point that we've had. I like to say that true allied and partner integration is based on trust, and this is where we build that trust. They've been super supportive in all facets, and then yeah, we've worked and integrated with them when we've been flying in the same vols and stuff, and then even just we have two LNOs that are staying in Darwin, and they're doing a lot of the integration, and we VTC set up and phone calls and stuff in order to just do the coordination, debrief with everybody yesterday, and we had a Singaporean mission commander who did a phenomenal job, and we're just there to get those lessons learned, and it's been awesome. Even though we're physically dislocated from our mates, our international mates, we're still getting the training we need. For them, it's ops normal. I have a phenomenal maintenance team, and they crush it. So when the jets get back, they do what they need to do to give us the lines we need the next day. And it's no different than being in any other TDY for us, whether or not it's red flag at Nellis or if it's here in Australia. So there'll be unique things that they'll work through depending on each and every base, back to the projo thing. But we generally identify those things whenever we come out for our site surveys and so on and so forth. And then we have mitigating things that we do for that, for getting gas and so on and so forth. And then we bring the supplement to help with the Aussies. And it's really easy working with Australia. Yeah.